Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to another review. Today, Steve Mason still sick, and today we're going to talk about the Animals of the Warrior Kingdoms by Sparrow Toys. And today we have Atreyu. Atreyu is crazy because, to me, he's a house feralist, but from what I'm learning, but it's just crazy to me because Atreyu reminds me of the Thundercats animated show from the 2000s, and I love everything about that. He just looks like it. He gives me those vibes. All he needs is like an add-on claw arm, and I'll just be excited. And as I've stated before, and you'll see in the other reviews, I'm genuinely surprised about how these things move, how good they are. And then, for the most part, the two out of the three that I got out the package came ready to go and was fantastic movement-wise. Like, I love it. So, the first thing I want to do is talk about our sculpt on this guy. Like, here we are. Like, look at that. This is a really solid sculpt. I'm really enjoying it. I'm going to turn down my brightness just a bit. Didn't realize how high it was. I'm going to turn it down ever so bit. So just give me a second. I'm a little sick, like I said. So trying to do my part. There we go. A little too bright there. But yeah, look at that. Look at this. Oh, yeah. And just like with Kale, we have that neck movement that allows that extra movement, right? Look at all this expressive to the side, up, down, and despite all the hair sculpting, he can just move all the way around. As far as our arms go, right, we can hit the T-pose with little to no issue. We have a little bit of a tucking problem here, but I think that's really on my end, just about how I move figures. But once you just kind of serve that in ever so, just a bit slower, you'll be fine, right? Hitting the T-pose with no problem. Then we have our bicep swivel. We have our beautiful double joint, and I'm going to pop the arm off for a second because I want to just double check on the gauntlets being removable. I don't even have the strength to remove hands. Wow. That sucks on my end. So let's do this off camera real quickly. There we go. Ooh, that took a lot out of me. So let's see. Yes. So just in case you wanted to do that, that Lino reference, you can actually remove a gauntlet, make it asymmetrical. In case you were wondering, this actually looks really, really nice even without it, right? I'm gonna pop the hand back on later. But as our torso section, as you can see, we have this nice ball joint here in the middle. We have a beautiful ab crunch going backwards, even so more beautiful going forwards. This is all soft plastic, so that means when you want to rotate the legs out, you shouldn't have too much of a problem. It's a little bit harder on these ones, whereas they don't let you go fully out, but you do go forward with no problem. We have a thigh swivel. We have a beautiful double joint. I do believe these are removable as well. Yes, they seem to be. And then we still have our super generous and lovely ankle pivot. Right? Goes forwards, backwards. All the good jazz. Right? So look at that. Beautiful, beautiful movement. Our beautiful butterfly joints, which I forgot to mention earlier. But if you just look at how the movement is, look at that. Just a ton of fun. If we don't talk about crouching poses, right? These guys literally can crouch with little to no issue. We can do a three-point stance technically. Let's get it in there. Yeah, we can technically do it. So I'm here for it. I really am. Like, these are just A1. Like, I've talked about it a lot. This is just A1. And the best part about these is that I just didn't know what I was getting into, which is why I'm super excited about that. And I may not seem that way because I'm hyped up on Dayquil and Vicks, right? So, but I'm gonna be honest, like, this has been pleasantly surprised to play with as I've been in the bed most of the time. I'm finally happy to be, for the most part, out of the bed, like, doing stuff. Because having the flu is serious when you haven't been sick in such a very long time. So look at that. Look at that. These look great. Now, without further ado, though, we're gonna jump into accessories. I'm probably not even gonna do the cut because I'm in such a good momentum. So let's just go straight through it and work it through, right? So, accessory-wise, we have this beautiful shield. I already had the handle put in, but you can honestly do it. You can just wiggle it out. You can put the handle on either side, so if you want to make them left or right-handed, you'll be totally fine. These are beautiful shields. Then we have our long broadsword. I really like the way this sword looks. And it's crazy because the contracts, it's an all-silver sword, so I was expecting something a little bit more gold. So that's a nice contrast. We have a knife or short sword, depending on who you are. Because if I'm a short guy holding this, this is probably going to be a mini sword. Considering this guy may be gigantic. Now, hand-wise, we have our open gripping hands right there on him out the gate. Then we have our closed fist for punching of the sword, looking really cool, being angry. And then we have our open action hands. These beautiful things, right? Last but not least, you'll also get a storage tab. And this tab is going to be used for a particular reason. And in my belief, I do believe this plugs into the shield. And this is how you're going to store it into the back. I hope I'm right about that, considering I don't have any sort of knowledge otherwise. But it looks like that's how you store the shield on the back, which I like. I like the idea of that, right? Shield storage. So now that we've done that, I do, however, need to take the time to get together for a size comparison. So I'm going to have a quick water break, blow my nose, and let's get to it. Yes, Riley. I'll see you guys in a bit. Hey, guys. Now we're going to jump into the size comparison. First thing, let's do it up against other AWOC figures. So let's jump into it. Here we are with the other two that I have. Looking real good. Hopefully, I can get photos done for these guys quickly. I'm not sure when these videos will be out, but I'm hoping they will be soon. So technically, they look like a modular line, but there are different body types. As you can see, he's like a medium build. This is more like a heavyweight build. We have our slender build. But I'm very happy with all three regardless, and I'm really going to enjoy it. I'm looking forward to it, these, because they all kind of bring something different to the table, especially with him and his smirk, more like the heroic type. This guy seems sort of like an anti-hero, so we're going to see where it goes with these. So, yes. Now we're going to compare with some other lines. Let's do some Mythic Legions, Motu, and Zesray stuff first, so let's do that. So, here we are with some Mattel. I have Sunman. I actually really, really like this figure. So here we are with Sunman from Mattel, looking really good. You see it's a little bit smaller, as in Sunman is taller and Ewok is smaller. Then we have the Zesray Studios. They seem a little bit perfect. Well, actually, yeah, the females seem to fit perfectly. And since the females are about the same height as the males, this actually really works in my favor. Since these guys are all like super people, I like the idea that they are bigger. So I'm okay with that, right? Next up, we're going to do some Mythic Legion stuff. So here we are with a 2.0 body. Here's Artemis Silvercord with the 2.0 body. Then I have a painted Barbarian Gladiator. I've been kit bashing. Shout out to Alex Richardson, who repainted this for me. This lovely, lovely color. Looks great, right? And as you can see, Legions actually fit really well in with this line. I feel like this is going to be a really nice go-to for these. Just in case you want to do Star Wars, because I feel like these guys can still fit in with Star Wars. Here we are with SHF Boba Fett. And funny thing, though, like I said, Black Series are about the same size as SHF. Most, not all, human-sized characters. So I feel like this works pretty well, right? Before I forget, here we are with Mezco Conan. And then we'll also do a Mezco Predator, because I feel like Predators could work really well here, too. Right, so here's Mezco Conan, and here is Mezco's Predator. Right, and just for the fun of it, here is a NECA Predator, aka the Greyback. He is a very tall guy, and even if I sit him behind, you can just see just how much taller he is, even in the background, just standing there over everyone. So that's always a good look, right? Let's remove these guys off to the side. Next up, we have some more human characters. So, I dropped a weapon. I'll deal with that later. Hopefully, I don't step on it. Here we are with Rollout from Valorverse, right? Here we are with Snake Eyes from G.I. Joe Classified. My kit bash Snake Eyes. So, as you can see, the human characters are a little bit smaller. Totally fine with that. As in, anthropomorphic animals are going to be gigantic, right? Next up, we have a Marvel Legends Moonmate, who I call him Moonmate. It's always funny. That's a joke between me and Kidra. Then we have a McFarlane the Witcher. Right? And that's a 7-inch line. And then last but not least, we'll throw my boy in Kuga, just for fun. As we know, we already technically did SHF, but let's make an appearance, right? So here we are with SHF Kuga. Even if we stand him straight up, he's the tiniest of tiny with AWOC characters. I really like these. The mobility of them are awesome. The modular parts, which means you can do some swapping. I can't wait to get some weapons too. I'm gonna get some stuff from Hard to Find Toys. Oh, Bonus, here is a Lightning Collection Dino Charge Blue. Right? So I'm going to do that. That was actually a lot to do for me at once. I wanted to blow my nose so bad. So I want to thank you guys for watching it as I sound very nasally. I want to thank you for sticking it out through these as I've been sick. And if I forget anything, I apologize in advance. Shout out to Sparrow Toys who reached out and was able to shin me some of these. I do appreciate it. And I've picked up more since then. So it's going to be cool. Hopefully some stuff will be shipping soon because I know the Kickstarter stuff started shipping. And thank you guys for watching as I've been doing a lot and a little all at the same time. So I appreciate sticking me out as I bust out a lot of content and disappear because my schedule is so full. So I really want to say thank you very much. So gang, drink your water. And as always, please, for real, be good, do good, and drink your water. Later, guys.